Keeping our hearts healthy is something many of us keep in mind on a daily basis. But right now, more than 5 million Americans are living with heart failure. This week, the American Association of Heart Failure Nurses are gathering in New Orleans to learn about a new research that can improve quality of life for patients and help patients live longer. Joining us now via satellite, Sarah Paul, a registered nurse practitioner who specializes in heart failure. Good morning.
Good morning. Glad to see you.
Good to have you with us this morning. All right. For anyone who doesn't know, explain what heart failure is and how it's going to impact a person's life.
Exactly. Heart failure is not in and of itself a diagnosis. It's the end result of other diagnoses. So people who have heart failure have had other heart problems, such as a heart attack, blocked coronary arteries of the heart, perhaps a leaking valve in the heart, or long-standing high blood pressure. So then eventually they are unable to get blood out of the heart to meet the needs of their organs and muscles. This results in fatigue, swelling, water retention that ends up in the lungs, and the patient becomes very short of breath. This is a big problem because people are surviving more and more with heart disease, only to develop heart failure later in life. So when patients retain water and the water fills their lungs, they end up in the hospital, and that's a big problem. It's the number one admitting diagnosis for people over age 65 in this country. So when patients are discharged after a hospital stay, about a fourth of those patients end up back in the hospital again. So it's very important to keep these patients out of the hospital, because the more they go back into the hospital, the higher the mortality. So we're here talking about a CardioMEMS device, which is made by St. Jude Medical. It's a device that is about the size of a paperclip, and it's inserted into an artery of the lung in the catheterization lab. So it's not a surgical procedure. It takes about 15 or 20 minutes, and the patient doesn't even spend the night in the hospital. But when the patient gets home, they have a pad that they lay on every day and a monitor, and they push a button, and that monitor sends information about how much water is in their lungs to their doctor or nurse's office. And we can monitor the amount of water building up in the patient's lungs. And if we see that they do start to accumulate water, we can call that patient and usually just have to adjust their medications. There's more information about this on heartfaileanswers.com if you're interested.
Well, there you go. For you as a nurse, it's got to be exciting to see this new technology come along and help people live much longer and happier lives.
It's very fulfilling to see patients have improved quality of life. It certainly is.
Well, thanks so much, Sarah, for joining us. And if you would like even more information about heart health info and statistics, you can head over to our website. It's roadshow.com.